EMP and CME. That is electromagnetic pulse and coronal mass ejection. Both events emit an intense wave of electromagnetic pulse. That's a solar flare and say a nuclear bomb detonated in our atmosphere. And most people are convinced that an ammo can will protect their electronics that they want to have after such an event, if it were to occur. And I'm here to dispel that myth, and I'm going to tell you how to fix it. So let's try a little experiment. This is my wife's phone. I'm going to dial her phone, let you hear what it sounds like. I have her permission. Okay, you hear what it sounds like. I'm going to put it in the ammo cam. Lock it down. Give it another call. Bring it over here just to make sure you can hear it. Okay. Let me tell you why that's happening. The lid has a rubber gasket all around here. That lid, that rubber gasket, prevents this lid from making contact with the bottom portion of the ammo can, thereby completely eliminating what you had hoped to accomplish by putting stuff in here. It's not a Faraday cage. If the top does not make contact with the bottom, basically you've left the whole top open. So what I'm going to do is remove this rubber gasket, fill that gap with aluminum foil. Now, I've already taken the liberty of doing this in the interest of time. So here we go. That lid there has the gasket removed and aluminum foil, tin foil, whatever. I get corrected on that all the time. Put back in there. So here we go. I'm going to put the phone in there. Oh, wait a minute. I didn't take it out. Okay. Phone still in there. Close this up. Give it a call. It's ringing. I won't show you the number. Still ringing. Still ringing. I'm going to let you hear some of the, when it answers. Well, it was nothing a good rap on the side of the camera couldn't fix. I'm an electronics expert, trust me. We proved that. These Faraday cages, or these ammo cans, will not make a Faraday cage unless you remove the gasket and line that with... It doesn't have to be tin foil, it could be a metal gasket, but the top of the lid and the bottom of the can have to make contact. And here's one other step that I take, just to give it two layers of protection. I take my electronics that I want to protect, I put them in a plastic Ziploc baggie. I wrap this in aluminum foil, tin foil, and then I put it in the can. Now in this can, you want to line it with cardboard, top, bottom, and all four sides, because you don't want this to come in contact with the outside metal. So what you've done is protect this with two separate layers of, I'm not sure what the word is called. I'm not an electronics expert by any mean, but I think it's called attenuation. And what it does is just prevent the electromagnetic waves from getting to your electronics. I honestly don't completely understand the science, but there's a lot I don't understand, like, well, anyway. So there you go. I think that's a pretty important thing to know. That gasket there is going to prevent you from protecting your electronics. So if you've counted on that, remove the rubber gasket and fill that gap up with tin foil. Protect these like I said, and you'll be double protected. Thanks for watching.